Hello friends, welcome to Global Online University. Friends, I am Bahubali Desai. In this video, we are going to discuss some important MCQs on macroeconomics for your upcoming UGC NET and SET 2021. Friends, if you have applied for KSET in the next month, we may expect the examination date. So if you are preparing in economics, you can go through this crash course. And friends, in this crash course, we are going to provide you 20 mock tests for paper 2 economics preparation. Here, each test will be having 100 MCQs with answers and also with detailed explanation. So totally, you will be prepared for 2000 MCQs here. And also friends, after attending the test, you will get the solution PDF of each test. And also friends, one more thing, we are going to provide you notes on all the 10 units. Yes, if you join for this crash course, you will get notes on all the units. And also you are going to get 1000 MCQs PDF. On each unit, you are going to provide 100 MCQs here. And also friends, we will solve previous year's questions of KSET as well as UGC NET with detailed analysis. And friends, all these 20 tests plus notes plus 1000 MCQs PDF are available only at ₹999. Friends, I think it is very minimum amount, and the comprehensive course is really worth for it. So if you want to join, you can contact these numbers. The numbers are displayed on your screen. You can just send a WhatsApp message also, we will respond to you. And friends, whatever materials we are providing, you can access through the Global Online University app and also through the WhatsApp group. So friends, I believe if you attend these 20 mock tests, you are going to increase your score in paper 2. If you score more in paper 2, it is very easy to clear KSET or UGC NET. And if you are really preparing for MS SET and also KSET, these tests are very helpful for your preparation. And friends, here you can see the schedule also from 1st June 2021, we are going to start new batch for economics preparation. Yes, in this new batch, daily you are going to get one test from 1st June 2021. Yes, daily one test will be there. In the morning, you will attend the test, and in the evening, we will send you the solution PDF. Okay, till 26 2021, we will complete the 20 test. With this, we are also providing you notes plus 100 and 1000 MCQs PDF. And friends, if you have any confusion, if you want to ask any questions, you are allowed. Yes, we will respond you within 24 hours. Yes, you can comment your queries in the comment box, or you can also send your doubts or any questions to this number. And also friends, recently we have started the economics crash course. Previously we were providing a paper 1, and in our paper 1 also from 1st June we are going to start the next batch. Yes, in batch 5 also we have completed all the 40 tests. So from 1st June we are going to start one more batch. So you can register if you are preparing for KSET. For KSET, from June 1st, we are going to start new batch. And friends, if you have any suggestions, yes, please comment in the comment box, or you can send me on WhatsApp also. Yes, your suggestions are welcome here. Please, if you have any good ideas, any suggestions, if you want us to improve our video lectures, in what way we are expecting to improve us, please comment your suggestions in the comment box. So let us move to the questions. Here the first question is, an increase in expected future income under Keynes theory would be, yes, when the people are expecting increase in their future income, what will happen under the Keynes theory? Yes, option A, increase savings. Option B, shift the consumption function upward. Option C, decrease consumption expenditure. Option D, shifts the saving function upwards. Yes, friends, when future expected income increases, yes, then the consumption function will shift upward. Yes, as you all know, according to Keynes, when income is going to increase, yes, when they are expecting increase in an income in the future, so now presently they will consume more, so the consumption function will move upwards. Yes, here you can see, according to change as the income increases, consumption also increases, but not in the same proportion, but it is less than the increase in the income. And what are the determinants of consumption here? Wealth, price level, interest rate, consumer expectations, etc. A change in any of these factors will shift the consumption function. Yes, in this question, the question was about price level. The question was about increase in the income. Yes, increase in the income. When income increases, the consumption curve will shift upwards. This is the consumption curve. And this is the income curve. Yes, when future income increases, consumption will move upwards. Yes, question number 2 is, which model of consumption bring the importance of current assets? Yes, very important question. There are 4 macroeconomic theories are there. Absolute income hypothesis, relative income hypothesis, permanent income and life cycle hypothesis. In our previous video also I discussed. Those 4 theories are very important. So, which model of consumption bring importance of current assets? Option A, absolute income hypothesis. Option B, relative income hypothesis. Option C, life cycle hypothesis. Option D, permanent income hypothesis. Yes, here the right answer is option C, life cycle hypothesis. Yes, in life cycle hypothesis, Modigliani will give importance to the assets. Yes, life cycle hypothesis was developed by F. Modigliani in the year of 1957. And the theory states that individual seeks to smooth consumption over the course of a lifetime borrowing in terms of low income and savings during periods of high income. Yes, it means here the Modigliani is giving importance to the lifetime income. Yes, so this model gives importance to the lifetime assets. Okay, here also you can see this curve also. Here up to here students, people are not earning anything, so they are taking loans for their life. Yes, in this stage they will take loans up to age of 20, so they are not doing any job. But from 20 to 65, yes, from the age 20 to 65, in this stage people will start earning and also they will start saving. Yes, they will earn income here and they will clear their previous loans, and also they will save for the retirement. Yes, again after the age of 65, again they stop working. Again after 65 there is no saving. Again saving will come down. But Modigliani says that the consumption, it is stable here. Okay, let us move to the next question. List 1, list 2, match the following ISLM theory, consumption ratchet, life cycle hypothesis, critics of Keynesian economics. Here Modigliani and Bromberg, Lucas and Sargent, Hicks and Hansen, James Dusenberry. Yes friends, while solving match the following questions, solve first very easy questions. As you all know, life cycle hypothesis is given by Modigliani and his student Bromberg, and ISLM theory also you know it is given by the Hicks and Hansen, and consumption ratchet and like critics of Keynesian economics. If you don't know also, you can find the answer here. First one is 3. Yes, in A and 3. You can eliminate these 2 answers here. And life cycle hypothesis, C is 1 here. So, the right answer will be option D. Yes, option D is the correct answer. Yes, ISLM is given by Hicks and Hansen. Consumption ratchet is given by James Dusenberry. Yes, consumption ratchet is given by James Dusenberry. Then life cycle hypothesis, Modigliani. Critics of Keynesian economics. Keynesian economics was criticized by Lucas and Sargent, 2 economists. Okay, next assertion and reason question. Assertion is, according to the life cycle theory of consumption, an individual level of consumption depends not just on current income but also on long run expected earnings. Yes, the reason is, individuals are assumed to plan a pattern of expenditure based on expected earnings over lifetime. Yes, according to life cycle hypothesis, as we all know, here the consumption is dependent on current income and also expected future income. Reason is, individuals are assumed to plan a pattern of expenditure based on expected earnings over lifetime. Yes, this is true here. So here the right answer will be option E. Both assertion and reason are true, and reason is the correct explanation of assertion. Yes, the life cycle hypothesis is an economic theory that pertains to the spending and saving habits of people over the course of lifetime. Please remember this sentence. The concept was given by Modigliani. Yes, the next question is, leverage effect is associated with option A, multiplier, option B, consumption function, option C, super multiplier, option D, accelerator. Yes, the leverage effect is associated with the super multiplier. What do you mean by leverage effect? Leverage effect describes the effect of debt on the return on equity. Yes, please remember it. Leverage effect, Santandre. This is going to express the effect of debt on the return on equity. And here you can expand it. Additional debt. It can increase the return on equity for the owner. Yes, additional debt, it can increase the return on equity for the owner. This applies as long as total return on the project is higher than the cost of the additional debt. Yes, in this way, leverage effect, it is going to express the relationship between debt and the return on equity. And there are two types are there. One is positive leverage effect. Another one is negative leverage effect. Here you can read, if the project return is 5% and the interest on debt is 3%, yes, it is worth raising even more debt capital. Yes, in this case, what will happen here? The company only has to pay 3% interest. Okay, the company has to pay 3% interest on the capital. Okay, but it generates a total return of 5%. Has less equity capital is required for the project, then it is known as the, this is very economical, so it is known as the positive leverage effect. And negative leverage effect is completely opposite to this. In this case, what will, okay, here, if the interest rate on debt exceeds the total return of the project, less money is generated with the help of debt financing, then it is negative leverage effect. Here what will happen? It will reduce the return on equity. Yes, here in positive leverage effect, the return on equity is more, but in negative, it is going to reduce the return on the equity. For example, with total return of 5% and interest of 6%, you pay more for the additional capital than you can earn it. It is an example for the negative leverage effect. Yes, next question is, in an hypothetical economy, given the value of MPS is equal to 0.2, the value of investment multiplier is, yes, here MPS they are given here, MPS means marginal propensity to save, it is 0.2, then what is the investment multiplier? Four options are given here. Yes, very easy, you know, multiplier is equal to, there are two formulas are there, one is 1 divided by 1 minus MPC. Yes, multiplier is equal to 1 divided by 1 minus MPC. Then one more formula is multiplier is equal to 1 divided by MPS. Yes, please remember these two formulas. Yes, okay, here the right answer will be option B, that is 5. So let us see, K is equal to 1 divided by MPS. Yes, MPS was given. MP was 0.2. So 1 divided by 0.2 is, it is pi. So option B is the right answer. The value of MPC. Yes, the value of MPC in the previous option A between minus 1 and plus 1, option B 0 and 1, option C between 1% and 10%, option D between 1 and 10. Yes, as you all know, the value of MPC is always between 0 and 1. So option B is the correct answer. Please remember it. MPC value always lie between 0 and 1. Yes, they are, and also please remember the formula to calculate MPC. MPC is equal to marginal propensity to consume is equal to change in consumption divided by change in income. Here C means consumption, Y means income, D means change. Yes, the next question is match the following: induced investment, foreign investment, autonomous investment, and social investment. And this is done by foreigners in order to earn profit. Driven by profit motive, done by government at various level, driven by social welfare. Yes, here the right answer is option C. Induced investment, it is done by the foreigners in order to earn profit. Foreign investment, yes, it is driven by profit motive. Yes, as we all know, foreigners invest in domestic country to earn more and more profit. Autonomous investment, it is social welfare motive. Then social investment, it is done by the government. Yes, the next question is Keynes' absolute income hypothesis states that as a person's, option A, income increases, MPC falls, option B, income increases, MPC rises, option C, income increases, MPC remains constant, option D, income increases, APC falls. Yes, here the right answer will be option C, income increases, APC falls. Yes. According to absolute income hypothesis, yes, when person's income increases, it will lead to fall in the average propensity to consume. Yes, because as Keynes said, rich people will spend more on consumption and they will save more. Yes, here you can see in Keynes consumption function, APC falls with rise in the income. This is because when income of the people rises continuously, they start consuming less and they start saving more. Yeah, because rich people want to save more, so as the income increases, APC will fall. Yes, the next question is, the relative income hypothesis states that the MPC is, option A, the same across different social classes, option B, lower for people with high income, option C, a function of disposable income, option D, decreases as income increases. Yes, here the right answer is, in relative income hypothesis, yes, the MPC remains same across different social classes. Yes, here the relative income hypothesis, the average propensity to consume, APC does not fall with increase in the income. If income of all family increases the same proportion, then consumption expenditure will remain unchanged. Yes, list one with list two, MPS is MPS. And MPC, here multiply values are given here. Yes, if you know these two formulas, you can easily calculate it. Multiplier is equal to, as I told, I think, 1 divided by 1 minus MPC. And one more is 1 divided by MPS. If you know these two formulas, it is very easy. Here the right option is option A. Yes, you can calculate and check. A is 3. If MPS is 0.2, multiplier is 5. Then B is 4. C is 1. D is 2. Yes, two formulas of multiplier. 1 upon 1 minus MPC and 1 upon MPS. The next question is, if the consumption curve is drawn through the origin, yes, it means option A, the marginal propensity to consume is 0, option B, consumption and income are the same, option C, autonomous saving is very high, option D, autonomous consumption is 0. Yes, if the consumption curve is drawn through the origin. Yes, if you draw the consumption curve from the origin in the long run, it means that consumption and income are same. Yes, at this level, consumption and income both are same. Yes, the consumption curve does not start from the zero, but the consumption curve will not start from the zero, because at zero level also there will be some consumption will be there, so it won't start from zero. But if we think that if the consumption curve start from zero, then consumption curve will start from the zero, then at this point income will is equal to consumption. Next question: shifts in the consumption curve are caused by all of the following except changes in option A income, option B interest rate, option C credit availability, option D price level expectations. The right answer is option D, price level expectations. Yes, next question is, for which of the following consumption function the value of the income multiplier is 4? Yes, four functions are given here. So here the right answer is option C, when consumption is equal to 200. So C is equal to 200 plus 0.75 y. yes, this is the correct answer. If this is the consumption function, then income multiplier will be 4. Yes, how to calculate it? Here you can see income multiplier is equal to K is equal to 1 divided by 1 minus MPC. And what is the MPC value? Yes, this is the MPC value. MPC value is 0.75. So 1 upon 1 minus 0.75, that is 1 upon 0.25. So multiplier will be 4. So the right answer is option C. Okay, friend, this is about our today's session. Here in our crash course for NET SET Economics 2021, we are providing you 20 mock tests for paper 2 economics. You will get the solution PDF of all 20 tests, notes you are going to get. We are also providing you 1000 MCQs PDF and previous year's questions also be solved here. So if you want to join, you can contact this number. And also for UGC NET paper 1 preparation also, we are providing you 60 tests. For Karnataka set, we are providing for paper 1, we are providing 40 tests, 1000 MCQs PDF, and then PDF of all the 40 tests, ebook we are providing you. If you subscribe for paper 1 and paper 2 at a time, you will get 50% discount. Okay, friends, thank you very much. I wish all the best to all NET and SET aspirants in economics. Thank you.